It's homecoming weekend at Penn State, where an all-stadium whiteout is the sight to see. Arriving to their latest test is 5-0 Michigan. With lessons learned, they've escaped close calls. Today, they're facing a Big Ten road challenge from a determined group. Penn State is ready to make a statement as Michigan tries to stay unbeaten.
If you owe $10,000 or more to the IRS or state,
Penn State won the toss. They deferred to the second half. Michigan will receive.
You know, Tess, along with these sanctions comes a lack of depth. And where it really shows up is on special teams.
A lot of run-ons, not walk-ons. Refers to them as run-ons, does Bill O'Brien out there on special teams. Sam Ficken to get our day started as Dileo and Northfleet back to return. It takes a bounce at the 21. And this is Drew Dileo. And he gets it out to the 30-yard line. The impact prayers are brought to you by Chick-fil-A.
Well, they're really simple for the Michigan team. It starts with Taylor Lewan, the All-American tackle. Came back as a big-time player. Toussaint, they're going to get a heavy deuce of running. Daquan Jones, a defensive tackle from Penn State. Jordan Lucas on the outside. They're going to have to be able to play their best games. Daquan Jones in particular. I expect a heavy dose of running, and Jones is going to have to carry the load on the inside.
A little window dressing here to get things going. I formation with Toussaint. And Fitz Toussaint is taken down for a loss by Daquan Jones.
That's what they need. Daquan Jones is going to have to play big all game long. Now, that's the first play, but you can see what Michigan wants to do. Last week, they experimented with Taylor Lewan, just putting them back and forth. They know that Daquan Jones is a force inside. He's probably better than their inside three. Expect to see a lot behind Lewan.
So Devin Gardner wearing that number 98 Legends jersey of old Tom Harmon, facing a second 13. And Gardner on the ground. He gets it out to the 31, where he's taken down by Kyle Baldwitz. Devin Gardner, who's run the ball well, has at least a rushing touchdown in 9 consecutive games. Turnovers have been really the defining factor of his season. You see the career numbers, 21 touchdowns framed against 14 interceptions.
Lattes, this is exactly where Penn State needs Devin Gardner to be. Third and long situations. They want to try to make him be a pure passer. Take the legs out from under him.
John Butler, the defensive coordinator, said that was the key. Make Gardner pass. Well, here's a passing situation. Sprints to the near side. Pressure comes, gets rid of it, and that was thrown to the outside of the intended target, Devin Funchess.
Nicely done by Malcolm Willis, coming up from the secondary to force that throw. Taylor had a chance to get to the edge, and Willis took it away and forced the throw.
So a 3-and-out in Penn State defense as Matt Weil is on the punt away with Jesse Della Valle and Von Walker back deep for the Nittany Lions. Oh! Della Valle keeps the legs going out to the 36.
There was an absolute decapitation on the field. The other returner just absolutely drilled the first man down.
That was Walker.
Oh, man, watch this. Watch right there, number 25. Look at that. I heard it up here. How far were you? That's Von Walker, number 25, and that is one right to the kisser.
You're giving it to Dennis Northfleet, the receiver and return man for the Wolverines. So here is the 18-year-old quarterback. Zwinak. And a good hard charging run by the junior running back, Zach Zwinak. There is number 47, Jake Ryan, who tore his ACL in spring practice, their best defensive player a year ago, who's been practicing, and they said they would make a decision if he could go today. Second and two. Play action with Hackenberg. And he gets his first pass of the day, complete for a first down to Brandon Felder. And with this matchup with the Penn State offense, a look at the impact players brought to you by Chick-fil-A.
Well, Allen Robinson is their big play guy. And Adam Brenneman's a guy you don't really know about, just a freshman. He has a huge upside. Frank Clark on the inside and Countess as the corner are going to have to play big.
Zwinak forces his way near the 40-yard line, tackled by Quinton Washington. Adam Brenneman, who you discussed there as an impact player, didn't see playing time last week, but he was a very highly touted recruit, and he's a guy who could be a difference maker for the young Hackenberg. Second and four. Play action again with time. Wobbly ball, and that is intercepted as it was Jared Wilson coming in underneath it. That was a wobbler by Hackenberg.
Not quite sure what the route combination was on the top side, but a nice job of getting the ball, making a pick.
Fifth interception thrown by Hackenberg. Michigan offense back out there when we return. You're watching number 18 Michigan take on the Penn State Nittany Lions. Due to time constraints, we're moving ahead in our coverage. Oh, dangerous throw, and he paid the price. Jordan Lucas. Lucas just sat on it, and Penn State is in prime position. And a little scuffle after the interception.
The long throw out there, but Lucas does a beautiful job of undercutting it. He read it right. Gallen made the cut, and he made his cut underneath his. The ball took a little long to get there, and Lucas makes the pick. Watch him see it. He's undercutting. That's what he did. They were undercutting Gallen. They were doubling Gallen. Lucas was the inside man. That's a great call by John Butler.
You worry about the confidence of a young quarterback like Hackenberg, who just threw a pick, and now this thing's served right up for Hackenberg in the Penn State offense. Zach Zwinak patiently taking his time and only finding a yard. Jordan Lucas, the sophomore who last week had a career high 9 tackles. He says, you know what? I saw that all the way, pointing at his eyes, yeah, reading Devin Gardner.
Yes, he may be saying that he saw it the whole way, but I'm going to tell you, that play right there was on John Butler. That's an undercut call. That's a great job by Lucas, but Butler put him in position to make it.
Empty set here on 2nd and 9 for Hackenberg. That is incomplete as he was looking for Bill Belton, the running back who was sent out.
I like what Bill O'Brien's trying to do there. So he knows you could get pressure down here. Greg Madison, the defensive coordinator for Michigan, he'll bring pressure down inside this red zone. So what you do is you spread everything out, and it's defined for the young quarterback, so he can see things a lot easier. Doing the same thing again.
3rd and 9, they can get a first down at the 4.
So Michigan shows 3 and drop 8. That's a really tough coverage to throw into. You should have time, but you'll have everything zoned off.
Plenty of time for Hackenberg to the end zone, and that's a touchdown. Brandon Felder, Penn State, jumps out in front.
Pess. That Lucas interception led to this. That's the first thing. The second thing, we said 3-man rush. We'll have lots of time. Now I want to show you the third and most important part. And that's Hackenberg looking like a young Tom Brady, standing in the pocket, not getting phased, being patient, and delivering a perfect strike.
Sam Ficken puts it through. Christian Hackenberg. Nice way to bounce back. As you see Bill O'Brien say, good way of settling down. You throw the pick, You get a chance, you take advantage. 12-yard touchdown throw to Brandon Felder, his first touchdown catch of the year. You're watching number 18 Michigan take on the Penn State Nittany Lions. Due to time constraints, we're moving ahead in our coverage. Fitz Toussaint, and this time he gets running room, and he does well with a gain of 12. Let's check in with Maria Taylor.
Down here, the Penn State defense is really locked in on the fight. Defensive line coach Larry Johnson said, if you want to fight with them, push them back 5 yards. That's how you swing. We've already won the first two rounds, so stick in it. It's about endurance in a game like this, guys.
It's the kind of game that Penn State wants it to be, Matt.
Exactly. They want to bring it back to them, to what they can do. That's just be physical.
First down option run by Gardner. Stiff arms his way for a first down run out to the 40-yard line. It's already been such an exciting day of college football. Much more to come, including Texas A&M and Johnny Manziel. Down there at the Grove, Ole Miss. That's after Michigan and Penn State right here at Beaver Stadium. Gardner pumps once, now takes a shot downfield, and wide open is Funchess. Touchdown, Michigan. Devin Funchess has turned into such a dangerous weapon for Devin Gardner. 59-yard touchdown catch by the sophomore tight end.
Yeah, well, they blew this coverage because you can see that he's going to be down here. They're going to come with a corner blitz off the side. And then as he gets depth, runs right back, right past the safety. Safety gets stuck in a spot. That's Amos. He makes the wrong choice, and it's six quick.
Brandon Gibbons' extra point is good. And John Butler, the defensive coordinator, said we need to do two things. Stop the run, make him throw, but watch out for Funchess. They were watching Funchess streak right into the end zone. Big play for the Wolverines. You're watching number 18 Michigan take on the Penn State Nittany Lions. Due to time constraints, we're moving ahead in our coverage. Third and 11. They bring pressure right up the middle. Gardner trying to escape it. Now he's going to tuck, run, cuts back, keeps his footing, and somehow gets it.
That's a phenomenal job by Devin Gardner. That's all on Gardner. They brought the pressure, and his feet picks up that first down on third and long. It's about numbers, so they're attacking protections. Jones gets in. Now watch him just take off. That's a great job by Devin Gardner.
Stephen Obing Ajapong had a shot at him after Jones and Carson were tracking him down, but what an extremely athletic play. On third and 11, he gets 12. Here's big Derek Green, 240 pounds, the highly touted prospect, a true freshman.
Derek Green's the one that I really wanted to watch. As you can see, these games are coming up here tonight on ESPN. But Derek Green is a big man, and he's young, and he's powerful, and he's got his weight down. And I've been excited to see this guy because on tape, he's dynamic.
Second and 7. Green stays in. Intercepted. How about this defense? Anthony Zettel. The backup defensive end dropping off in coverage. He has shown some big playability, and he made a real big play there.
What you're going to see is Zettle on the top, and he's going to drop into coverage. Reason they're doing that is they're bringing pressure from the strong side. Again, with Willis, it's a zone blitz. And so as soon as he reads it, he thinks it's man, and here comes Zettle settling underneath. Nicely done on the pick.
How many times can you say you see a 98 intercepting 98? Here's Hackenberg now. Up top and in. Christian Hackenberg to Jesse James.
Hackenberg's got great protection. And when he has protection, he can set his feet and throw. He puts it right on the money. Nicely done by James of going up and getting it at his high point.
6'7" frame, and he went up and took it down. Penn State, two touchdowns with a short field, both set up by interceptions. You're watching number 18 Michigan take on the Penn State Nittany Lions. Due to time constraints, we're moving ahead in our coverage. ESPN College Football Primetime presented by Hampton Hotels. Glad you're with us here on a beautiful day. Penn State up 14-10 with aerial coverage provided by Goodyear. Everything Goodyear has learned making tires that go the distance inspires what they roll into yours. Goodyear, more driven. An all stadium whiteout here at University Park, Pennsylvania. Third down and 8. Let's see what Hackenberg's been able to do on third downs. 2 for 3. They have the touchdown pass on a third down to start the game. And he gets the chains moving here as he finds Kyle Carter.
This is really smart by Bill O'Brien and this offense. As they're switching off, they're going to hurry up, trying to catch Michigan not lined up.
A little bit of up-tempo now from Penn State, and Bill Belton gets to the outside off of it and was taken down at the 46-yard line. You saw Michigan still trying to get to the line of scrimmage as O'Brien took advantage.
Thomas Gordon saved the big play.
Now they stick with the tempo. And they get it complete, and Robinson makes a man miss for a Penn State first down.
Yeah, this is what went on in that third down. They rolled coverage to Robinson and singled on the top side, and that left the tight end one-on-one. Hackenberg took advantage of it.
Greg Madison trying to get those defensive calls in very quickly as Bill Belton just goes for a yard.
So, Tess, here's what happens when they roll coverage. That means you're going to take one of the safeties, and he'll move to Robinson's side to stay on top of him to take away the deep threat. And when you do that, the other safety moves to the middle field, and it singles the other receivers up to the top.
There is Robinson matched up with Taylor here. Second down and 9. Pressure coming. Gets rid of it. Gets it complete to Jesse James. First down, Nittany Lions.
They're going hurry up again. Bill O'Brien's liking this. Fast pace after the first down.
Hackenberg leaning on those tight ends now. And this will go for a loss of 1. Ojemudia with the tackle that time.
We talked to you early in the game about Adam Brenneman.
Mm-hmm.
Well, you can take Adam Brenneman, forget that, and it's been Jesse James. It's the tight end position that's been big.
Play action now. Oh, and he looked for James again, went through his hands as he was getting ready to turn upfield.
And there was nothing but green between he and the first down marker. And that's on Jesse James.
Third down and 10. Empty set for the 18-year-old kid quarterback. And he's touted for a year and a half as the future of the program. They only bring three against Hackenberg. And he's able to come up with it. Brandon Felder, second of the game.
Great catch by Felder, but watch Hackenberg puts it the only place he can. It's behind. He needed Felder to come back, and he beats Avery with a big body.
Now, there are those moments in a young man's development that just happen, like this first half with three touchdown passes on nine completions. You're watching number 18 Michigan take on the Penn State Nittany Lions. Due to time constraints, we're moving ahead in our coverage. Second and eight. And that time they fill the hole with yet another tackle for loss, Daquan Jones. In the last series, Glenn Carson must have been taking notes. Because this is exactly what you put forth.
Number 40, and then you come downhill and you make decisions. You know, the interesting thing about football is every step you're making a decision. Glenn Carson's made some very good decisions here tonight. He's been physical, he's been coming downhill. Defense is about discipline tests. You have to fill your gaps. Everybody has an assignment. You have to own that ground. Carson's done a nice job tonight.
Majority of the rushing yards have come from the quarterback, Devin Gardner. Toussaint and Green have been stopped. Now a third and 10. Michigan came in leading the Big Ten in third down conversion rate at 54%, but just one of six so far here at Penn State. Gardner steps up and throws a strike, and Devin Funchess is turning into such an incredible target for him.
We got a Michigan guy down.
And it happens to be their best pro prospect, Taylor Lewan.
He might be their best player in this field. Taylor Lewan is an incredible player. He would have been a number one pick a year ago.
A very high first round pick, and he decided to come back. They'll tell you he's the best offensive lineman in the country when they grade him out. Decided to stay for his final year. And this is a young man who's one of only nine Michigan offensive linemen in history to start all 4 years.
Tess, I know this. All those things are nice, but I know that kid. That is one tough sucker. For him to be down, he does not want to be down. He's fighting every ounce to get off the field.
Look at just the way he's walking off the field. Let's watch here, left side.
Got hit up high.
Yeah, it was Deion Barnes when he was, Lewan was locked up with his matchup, and it was Deion Barnes who came in, hit him on the side.
Let's hope he's all right. That's a fun player to watch.
So one of the very best linemen in the country steps off for Michigan as they get a first down after that completion to their tight end. And now on the option is Gardner. And they pursue down the line again with Carson.
That's just good team defense. You have to be able to protect the edge as we're watching Lewan, hoping he's fine. And then when that happens, it comes into your safeties and your corners. And when you're playing a zone defense, your corners, they've got to, if they don't make the tackle test, they have to turn it back inside so a guy like Carson can make the play. And they've done that tonight.
Jordan Lucas, who had an interception earlier tonight that set up a Penn State touchdown. Everybody is helping in against the run. Second and nine. And they go with the inside screen this time, and that never had a chance as Funchess didn't have any open real estate. Instead, it was Baldwin and Carson coming in for the tackle.
One thing that I noticed on the Penn State defense as we get ready for third and long is they don't have great awareness in the screen game. I expected to see more screens coming out of Michigan. That time, Penn State played it well.
And here on third down and eight, the All-America left tackle is back in the game. Taylor Lewan, what a great sign for Michigan to see him back in there. They pick up the pressure. And that is incomplete. A flag comes down as you saw Adrian Amos try to come in and swipe with that hand. And he was matched up with Jeremy Gallen.
That's not a good sign.
And you see
Taylor.
The pain on the face of Taylor Lewan as he went out there and tested it. And now he comes right back over to the bench.
Holding. Defense. Number 10. 10-yard penalty. Results in an automatic first down.
Now they're actually calling that on Trevor Williams, Todd Gerling, our referee.
This is Amos and Gallen
right
there. Number
four. Yeah, that's number four on the hold.
That's a good call. He had him on the top.
They correct themselves. It was Amos with the coverage.
And even with his right hand, he had him in the route also when he grabbed the top of his shoulder. Good call.
So a first down for Michigan at the 45. Derek Green, the lone back. Gardner, he escapes the pressure for a moment. Almost a spectacular effort by C.J. Olonian.
But Tess, more than that, he prevented probably 6 points. Two people behind him completely open, and Olonian, with that outstretched 6'6" arm of his, watch the height he gets. Funchess is behind him.
Funchess was just waiting on it.
That's a big play.
C.J. Olonian backpedaling, 6'6", goes up and is able to get his big mitt on the ball. Second and 10, design quarterback run. Taken down at the 40, will be third and 5. And it was Amos with the tackle of Gardner.
Well, Devin Gardner has been their entire offense. You could see him in the last three games and the interceptions, the turnovers is kind of what hurt him. Tonight, you can see 80 yards, he's got two picks. The difference for Devin Gardner in this game, his feet have bailed him out of some situations, and here we are in third and 5. You have to defend both his arm and his feet.
Funchess split out wide. Clock was coming down, that play clock. Ball is loose. That is a sack, fumble, recovery. Penn State, Daquan Jones. It was C.J. Olonian coming in, and Jones falling on it.
Yes, that's the second big play. As you look at the play clock down to zero, that should have been whistled.
This should have never happened.
And it wasn't. And Olonian with the sack fumble. They're gonna. That's going back upstairs. We're gonna check it.
Rolling on the field was a fumble recovered by Penn State. The previous play is under further review.
They're reviewing the fumble on the field. Devin Gardner, three turnovers, the two interceptions, and now this fumble. And the word we're getting from Steve Newman, the replay official, is they are looking at the progress of the ball, and they'll see where this came to an end.
Nobody blocked Olonian. Nice job of awareness. Just slap the ball out when you have that opportunity. And big old Daquan Jones on top of it. Tess, the guy who's been, this is a great series for Olonian, but the guy who's really been a man up front has been Daquan Jones, number 91. Watch the awareness of the throwing motion, then you slap over the top and gets the ball out.
Came forward, came back, and then... And Alani swiped in, so... You know, the message we got from Steve Newman, not exactly what they were looking for. Clearly, they were looking at the motion of the hand. And it is a fumble and a recovery as the All-American left tackle, Taylor Lewan, heads to the locker room. So Penn State back on offense. As Winack to the 42. And Lewan with a shoulder to lean on as he heads to the Michigan locker room. Remember, they shuffled the offensive line a week ago, but he's the one big anchor they have. Second and six. Bill Belton. Little pad leverage to the 39. That was Desmond Morgan with the tackle.
Tess, when Bill Belton's in the game, this is a more, it's a faster offense. It's a more dynamic offense. Just a junior. He's a lot better than he was a year ago. But what he gives you is he gives you some make you miss in there. He's got a little bit of wiggle to him, and he's got some speed to get to the edge. Without Belton, they don't get to the edge well.
No, Zwinak is 6'1", 240. Between the tackles kind of guy. Here's third and two, and it was down near the shoelaces of Adam Brenneman.
That's completely on Hackenberg again. He had Brenneman wide open. Hackenberg pulled the string on it, didn't put it where he needed to be.
So Penn State will come on a punt away with Alex Butterworth. And after the sack and fumble, the Michigan defense with a stop. And it took a bounce, and it went into the end zone.
Chocolate chip cookie just got better.
Introducing Papa John's new mega chocolate chip cookie. Add one to any.
ESPN College Football Primetime presented by Hampton Hotels. Great atmosphere here with the all-stadium whiteout. Not so great for undefeated number 18 Michigan, trailing 21-10. It was the Devin Gardner show, basically. It was all put on him. Now, he did have the three turnovers, but nothing conventionally being produced from the run game of Michigan.
Yeah, Tess, what you just said, that's significant. It's the game is completely on Devin Gardner's shoulders. And while it may be unfair, that's what they're showing here tonight. The Michigan offensive line has not played well. Taylor Lewan out. Penn State's front seven has dominated them. They will have to pick it up in the second half to take some pressure off of Devin Gardner.
Taylor Lewan, the All-America who protects the blind side of Devin Gardner. I took a peek here, Matt. Didn't see him come out of the locker room for the second half of this game. As Penn State will get the ball first to start things off. Discover Game Changer is brought to you by Discover Card.
Well, the biggest game changer in this game has been the turnovers. Been the turnovers in the first half by on the arm of Devin Gardner. And Penn State has been able to capitalize on him on two separate picks.
Two interceptions, also fumbled once, and Penn State was able to cash in on both the Lucas interception and the Anthony Zettel interception, setting up touchdowns as Christian Hackenberg, the true freshman quarterback, had three touchdown passes in that first half. This could be a scoop and score. Frank Clark, could he? Yes! What a start to the second half for the Wolverines.
That's exactly what Michigan needed. They needed a game-changing play, and they got it. Zwinak fumbles, and Clark picks it up, and he's gone. Nicely done by James Ross III. He's the one who knocked the ball out of the hands of Zwinak right there. Well-placed, hand on the ball, and then watch Clark rumble to the end zone.
And he's an athletic player, Frank Clark. Get the ball in his hands, he can do something with it. Guy who came to Michigan at about 220 pounds, a defensive back in high school who grew into a freakishly athletic 273-pound defensive end. And could you possibly have a better start in need of a second half comeback than that? 21-17, just 10 seconds in. Let's check in with Maria Taylor.
Well, that's certainly not the start that Bill O'Brien wanted. And coming out for the second half, he said that one thing his team was doing was playing aggressively and not making any mistakes. So it's interesting to see that that is the first thing that happens on the field to start the second half. But he also says he wants to have more play action out of his offense, and he wasn't quite satisfied with their performance in the first half, guys.
All right, Maria. As Frank Clark has pulled Michigan to within four. Talked about Bill O'Brien. Look at the reaction by O'Brien.
Bill O'Brien knows.
Can't give it away.
Yeah, this team can't make mistakes and expect to win. And they know that. Their margin for error is small. Nice play by Ross, though. Nice awareness of where the ball is and knocking it out.
Here is Geno Lewis. And Lewis is taken down at about the 26-yard line. So Hackenberg and Devin Gardner dueling here in State College, and the three touchdowns by the freshman, the difference as it stands now. Those two interceptions both set up Penn State touchdowns.
That's an interesting thing with young quarterbacks, and both of these guys are. What happened in the first half is meaningless. They've got to be able to pick up from here, and it's a whole new game in the second half.
Zwinak fumbled, and now Bill Belton is the running back. Here is that play action that Maria talked about. Hackenberg. Oh, that was dangerous right on the mitt of Frank Clark as he went against the grain a bit, and Clark dropped back into coverage. Jabril Black was coming after Hackenberg.
Nice job of Hackenberg managing the pocket, and he pulls the string on a couple times. He had Bill Belton. He's getting a little bit of frustrated back there, and he's got to calm himself down.
Delay handoff on second and 10 as Belton fights for maybe 2 yards that time. It'll be third and long. James Ross, the third, with the tackle. He had that forced fumble moments ago.
It's Greg Madison, their defensive coordinator, and he knows in order for them to have success here, his defense is going to have to pick up the pace better than what it did in the first half.
He says, this is a group that I have to coach every phase, every second.
I like what they're doing here. See, that messes up your protections, Tess. You get guys moving around, they can't really identify who they have to be able to handle. Usually it's five down in the backer, but when you're moving like this, you have to wait till it shows itself.
Pressure comes at Hackenberg as he released it to the outside of Richie Anderson. It was Black again.
Nice job of good coverage in the backside and then forcing him out. That was Jabril Black. He got a little bit of pressure.
Number one will be on ESPN2 tonight. Georgia Tech BYU is an interesting matchup of styles. And then Johnny Football down there at Ole Miss. That's your capper here on ESPN. Now Michigan is right back in it thanks to the scoop and score by Big Frank Clark. You're watching number 18 Michigan take on the Penn State Nittany Lions. Due to time constraints, we're moving ahead in our coverage.
ESPN College Football Primetime, brought to you by Toyota. Let's go places.
Well, that's Nittanyville with all the tents and the students camping out for their football tickets as the football players deliver pizzas to them. And then they had a dunk contest last Wednesday night. You got the basketball team judging it. Here's Bill O'Brien. Bill O'Brien, how's the vertical on the former linebacker from St. John's Prep back in Danvers, Mass. Trying to get up there.
Hey, Tess,
in the dunk contest at Nittanyville.
You can't question the result. He got the two.
That's right. Well, he's that kind of guy. That's how he would coach it. So Penn State did their job defensively. And now Hackenberg, that's off the hands of Richie Anderson. As the flag is down back at the 29-yard line, the pressure came from Cam Gordon.
Shot block. Offense. Number one. 15-yard penalty. Repeat first down.
Yeah, and it's a good call. And it's on Bill Belton, the running back. And the reason is you're going to see that the defender was engaged, right? He's coming back here, and he's going to cut him. And so when you get somebody from the top, they're going to call that every play. That's a good call by the official.
So a first and 25 after the penalty. Hackenberg. And Belton couldn't hold on to it as he turned his head, and the ball was right there on him. It was a crazy day in college football. Clemson was threatened by Boston College, but they ended up coming back to win. And now we can announce that next week, College Game Day, built by Home Depot, will be back at Death Valley. Florida State and Clemson, the big showdown in the ACC, and Game Day will get it all started next Saturday morning. And it's second and 25, the catch made by Anderson.
Richie Anderson is the son of the player Richie Anderson, who played in the NFL for a long time and played here at Penn State. And that guy, he's not a real big guy, but he's got some quickness. He's got a little bit of Wes Welker's type of style to him, Tess.
Came in as an early enrollee, and they're very high on what he could deliver down the road here for this team. Third and 18. And there's the other true freshman. Now, Hackenberg didn't enroll early. Came in this summer, and amazing to think how quickly he has progressed. Oh, and there's a mistake by the young man as Ramon Taylor picks him off.
Ramon Taylor drew a bead on it and saw it perfectly. And Brandon Felder, 85, didn't get his head turned around.
And Hackenberg tried to just muscle it in there, just eyeballing him.
You see him right up on the top side. Now he's sitting back in his zone, and his eyeballs are back because you have a long way to go. See how his eyes are there? He was able to make the break before the receiver.
And now a golden opportunity for Michigan. Gardner pulls it from the gut of Toussaint, and he takes off downfield. And Devin Gardner with a good run inside the 10. First and goal, Wolverines.
Watch Devin Gardner. Very deliberate. His eyeballs are right on Hull.
Boy, he rode that well, didn't he?
And as soon as Hull just leaned on the inside, he knew he could get to the edge.
That's good old-fashioned, brilliant ball handling option football. Ride that baby until you got to pull it. And now it's first and goal. Here he goes again. And this time he is met just before he got to the 5-yard line. Olanian was the first to make contact with him. Big chance for Michigan off of the interception.
His helmet came off, so he's going to have to come out for
a play.
That's
Shane Morris, the true freshman, who's strapping it on.
Test this Michigan offensive staff, Al Borges, the offensive coordinator, he knows exactly what he's got to do right now. He knows his most productive guy is Devin Gardner.
Now, interestingly enough, they can use a timeout if they chose to and avoid the rule of your helmet coming off having to come out. But instead, they don't use a timeout and send Shane Morris, the true freshman, the 5-star recruit, into the game.
Now, if you're a Penn State defense, you're betting on a run right here.
Second and goal, and the true freshman Morris is in the game. It's Toussaint. That goes nowhere. It's a tackle for loss. Mike Hull.
And so that's exactly what John Butler bet on. He's saying, okay, you got the freshman in the game. He's going to hand this ball off. I'm going to bring 11 guys to the line of scrimmage, which is what they did. Sets up this third down with Gardner back in the game. Watch how they attack everything. There's 11 shirts at the line of scrimmage.
Fourth time That Toussaint has been tackled for a loss. Third and goal as old number 98, new number 98 comes in. Incomplete. Devin Funchess turned around, had a chance, but they don't connect. He was covered by Lucas.
That ball was a good enough ball to catch. Funchess had his hands on it. It's on the back shoulder where it has to be. That's completely on Funchess. That should be 6 points. Gardner had the ball there, but Penn State comes up with a stop.
And Brandon Gibbons, the fifth-year senior, talented kicker. Made from 47 earlier, this from 23 to draw to within one. And he just punches it through. So the interception turns into a field goal. 10 points off the two Penn State second half turnovers for Michigan. You're watching number 18 Michigan take on the Penn State Nittany Lions. Due to time constraints, we're moving ahead in our coverage. Here's Belton testing the right side, able to get an edge on that corner. And he drives ahead right near that line to make. And he gets it, a first down for the Nittany Lions.
So what Belton gives you is what you just saw. They can get an edge when he's in the game. He's got a little bit of juice, and he can get to places Zwinak can't get.
Play action, Hackenberg is going to go to Belton out of the backfield. And he gets 8.5 yards that time as he was met by Taylor.
I think one of the things that Bill O'Brien has done with this offense today is taken more off the plate of Hackenberg.
Yeah, simplify it.
I'm seeing more coming from the sideline than I had seen.
Well, he talked about giving him those checks at the line. Here's second and one, and Belton fights his way for 1.5 yards and a first down for Penn State.
Tess, I like this Belton kid. I like the way Belton's playing. He's got some toughness to him, and I think that was the question with him on whether he could really shove it up on in there and be physical. You knew he had some speed and make you miss, but I like what I see there.
He's a better receiver out of the backfield than some of the other options. So Zwinak fumbled, and Belton getting some extended time here. And there is Zach, the 240-pound junior. First down, Hackenberg to pass. And wide open was Allen Robinson coming back to the outside as he dug in and gets the first down for Penn State.
Well, that's Ramon Taylor that he's working on. And what they're seeing is the big cushion. Now, what you have to remember as a receiver and as a play caller, as soon as those hips get turned, Tess, you make your break and the ball should be online. They're not going to recover. So he's reading Ramon Taylor's hips.
And it's a good-looking drive. As you can see, they cross that green line, the field goal range of Sam Ficken. Belton works it to the 30-yard line.
So right now, this Michigan defense has to find a way to be able to find, to not let allow Penn State to be balanced. That's what Penn State's enjoying right now. It's a little bit of balance between the run and the pass. But again, big cushions on Allen Robinson on the outside.
Oh, he got gobbled up by Jabril Black. And Hackenberg is slow to get up as Black came charging in.
That's what they needed, Tess. They needed a big play from somebody. And Jabril Black is the guy who provides it. You're going to watch him, number 55. See, they screwed up the protection and didn't block him.
Bill Belton didn't get a piece as Black was circling around. And he drove the 18-year-old quarterback right into the ground. So now what was manageable down and distance throughout this drive is 3rd and 14. And here's Belton. And inside the 29-yard line, so within the range of Sam Ficken, the junior place kicker.
I like that play call by O'Brien. Knowing you're going to probably, it's 3rd and 15, they're going to sit back a little bit. They don't want to give up the first down throw. So they're going to be a little softer in coverage. He takes advantage underneath with a screen.
And there is number 27, Adam Geiger, who's never played in a game before, and he's the holder tonight on this 45-yard attempt by Thicken. And this is a nice turnaround story for this young man, Sam Thicken, who really had a tough start to last season. Remember, week two was 1-for-5 on field goals, costing that game at Virginia. But he took some advice, and Coach O'Brien says, the most improved player on our team, the place kicker.
Well, take a good look at it. You can see that Oregon's finding the gas pedal, but there's some tough games, and the meat of schedules is coming up. Now, that Ole Miss game test, we talked about it earlier, but that one's on Bo Wallace. It's completely on. They have great young talent around them. They need him to be the trigger man.
Drew Dillio on the return. And Dillio out to the 26. It's one of the great scenes in college football. Penn State All-Stadium whiteout, and our aerial coverage of it is provided by Goodyear. Everything Goodyear has learned making tires that go the distance inspires what they roll into yours. Goodyear, more driven. Look at that scene. 107,000 plus to see unbeaten Michigan take on Penn State. Here's Gardner.
Oh, man.
Able to get past that rush, and he connects with Gallen. Jeremy Gallen out to midfield.
That is a great job by Devin Gardner. Daquan Jones was all over him. They tried to double him. He defeated the block in front of him, and then they tried to hit him with Toussaint. He shakes that and finds Gallen down. That's outstanding by Gardner. Oh, man, look at a wrecking ball.
Gardner again the pass. And that was off the mark.
It's like they said on the sideline before this series, look, Gallen's the guy to get the ball to. Get him the football. And that's a good game plan.
Just two catches for 22 yards tonight for Jeremy Gallen. Now 32 straight games with a catch. Tough receiver, good route runner. He's really come on. With Gardner as the quarterback, they're very close friends. They work out together. They developed a really nice relationship in the course of the past year. Second and 10. That ball was batted at the line of scrimmage. And
that's picked.
Was it picked? Let's see what they say. They say it hit the ground as C.J. Ohlonian was up there deflecting it. And Austin Johnson tried to control it. But they say that it hit the ground before Johnson was able to get his hands underneath it.
They come with a blitz to the inside. Yeah, it hit. That's a good call.
But once again, Ohlonian is getting up with that 6'6" frame and making things difficult. Let's see what Gardner comes up with on third and 10. Incomplete.
Flag
comes in as Adrian Amos had coverage on Jeremy Gallen.
That's a good call on Gallen. Gallen had position and Amos came over the top of him, and the official made the right call.
Came right through his back.
I'm surprised.
Pass interference. Defense, number 4. Spot foul. Automatic. First down.
Test. I'm surprised at John Butler, their defensive coordinator for Penn State, because he's bringing pressure and locking guys up man-to-man. Yeah, that's a great call. He held them early and then came through them also.
Every which way, and there is John Butler, first-year defensive coordinator here at Penn State. Guy who coached in the Ivy League at Harvard and then down with the head ball coach at South Carolina, now with Bill O'Brien. First down, play action. Gardner with time. And he muscled that ball to Jeremy Gowan, and it hit the grass. Gowan tries to go down, but you see he trapped it just before his hands could get underneath it here. Gowan now to the near side on second and 10. And here goes Gardner. First down, Michigan. Right tackle Michael Schofield had a nice block for Gardner there. Well, watch 75.
And watch 21, Jeremy Gowan on the outside, because if you're going to have any success running that ball with your quarterback, your receivers have to be able to block as well.
As Taylor Lewan, the All-America left tackle, looks on, left the game before the half with an injury. Gardner looking for real estate and spinning his way for about 3.5 yards. So Taylor Lewan out of the game, and Eric Magnuson, the 6'6", 285 redshirt freshman, steps in.
And not an easy position for just a young freshman. They're going against a pretty good defensive front, but he's got what he has. Just looking right away, he's got nice long arms, and if you're Magnuson, you got to get those hands on him and get good separation and move his feet. He's been doing that.
Magnuson at right tackle. Schofield moves over to left tackle as they have to juggle things without one of the top NFL prospects. Second and 6. And Gardner, when he makes a decision to go, he's downfield quick, and he picks up the first down.
So at one point, what's going to have to happen is, you can see what Michigan's game plan is now. If they don't have it, then Gardner's taken off and running. So for on the Penn State side, defensively, you're going to have somebody start to mirror him.
And you see John Butler sending in the late substitution there as he was waiting to see the personnel grouping from Michigan. The numbers on Gardner tonight: 98 rushing yards. Here's Toussaint now, and he just has not been able to find much.
Boblitz on the inside, Glenn Carson on the inside, but you're right. This Michigan offensive line has not moved this defensive front of Penn State. Gardner has been their offense. We said at the beginning of the game, and then again at halftime, he's not disappointed. He has been the entire offense.
A couple of turnovers got Michigan to close the gap here against Penn State. And now, can it be the one-man show of Devin Gardner here coming up in the final half minute of the third quarter? It can. Jeremy Gowan. Well done by Devin Gardner. And Michigan has taken the lead.
What a fantastic series by Devin Gardner. And now, there's a couple things. One, nice protection. He's able to step and throw, and the ball is perfectly thrown. And watch Gowan. The difference in the route is at the top of the route. Trevor Williams has his eyes back inside looking at Gardner, and the ball's going past him. Gowan for 6.
And Michigan has roared back, trailing 21-10 at the half. Devin Gardner capping a 9-play drive, 73 yards, and connecting with Jeremy Gowan. Oh, that familiar number 21.
Hey, Steven, what kind of...
You're watching number 18 Michigan take on the Penn State Nittany Lions. Due to time constraints, we're moving ahead in our coverage.
You gotta go higher.
Joe Tessitore, Matt Millen, Maria Taylor, and those wacky ones with you here at Beaver Stadium. Start of the fourth quarter, 27-24, as unbeaten Michigan had a very strong third quarter. It started just 10 seconds in with the fumble recovery brought back for a touchdown by their defensive end, Frank Clark. And they outscored Penn State 17-3.
That's a free play.
Flag is down as they run straight ahead with Belton.
Defense, number 76. That penalty's declined. Play resulted in a first down.
Johnny Football's coming up later tonight. For now, we'll see how things will play out with Michigan and Penn State.
Allen Robinson still has not been or had a significant role in this game. Credit the Michigan defense, but now it's turning into crunch time. It's time for him to show.
Came in seventh in the nation in receiving yards. Non-factor so far. And the pressure came on Hackenberg. That was Joe Bolden.
Yeah, they're starting to take a couple chances. And this is Greg Madison, the defensive coordinator, taking a couple more chances, and they're going a little bit more single coverage to the side of Allen Robinson.
There's Quentin Washington and Jabril Black. That group up front for Greg Madison's defense. Second and 10. And going against the grain is James, and it gets him the first down as Jesse James took that inside step back and got the necessary yardage.
Jesse James has been his main weapon.
Little up-tempo now out of Penn State. This worked earlier, and it works with Bill Belton for 12 yards.
This is the better offense with Bill Belton as the halfback.
Haven't seen Zach Zwinak since that fumble to start this second half.
Now this Belton's got some juice. Belton can make you miss, and he gets to the hole quick.
And this time, able to just pick up a couple of yards.
And so what does that mean with a quicker back to the hole? That means as an offensive line, you don't have to hold things as quick. You get into them, Belton's past you, and then you're on to the next level.
They're up at the line with the play clock at 31 and snapping at 29. That was a soft thrown ball with a flag down, but they are able to complete it right at the sticks to Brandon Felder.
That'll be declined. It's a first down.
Felder has two touchdown catches tonight, the second of which was a spectacular effort. So this is a good-looking drive by Penn State here.
And smartly called by the sideline.
Illegal substitution. 12 men on the defense. That penalty's declined. Play resulted in a first down.
And that's why I referenced how fast they were getting to the line of scrimmage with
exactly.
The play clock still at 32.
Yeah, and
that's
so,
the result.
And they call this NASCAR, and they pick it up, and that's the intended result, is to get you out of position and not ready for the snap, and you take advantage of it.
You got big 300 pounders jogging off, and Hackenberg was snapping the ball. First down now. He's going to take a shot for Robinson. Overthrown by about a stride.
Tess, when you have the opportunity in games like this and you have your best player open, you can't miss it. Now he beats Countess on the double move. Countess's eyes go back inside. Robinson's clear. When that happens, as a quarterback, you throw the ball at him. You don't try to lead him. You throw it when he's wide open. You throw it right at him.
Here's Jake Ryan, number 47 for Michigan, as he is back from the torn ACL he suffered in the spring. He had a fourth and one stop earlier tonight. Now he's out there on second and 10. Let's see if he gets after it. Here he comes. And there goes Hackenberg to the end zone, and once again overthrows Jesse James this time.
Just a two-man route down the field. Good protection. Hackenberg steps up, but at one point here, He's got to realize you can't get everything back at once, and you don't need to. Continue to work your inside game. Now, of course, it's 3rd and 10. He's got to get to the sticks. But his tight ends have been the most productive. They're showing pressure. Man-to-man on the outside.
Play clock down to 2. They only bring 3. And that's all they needed. Pressure came. And Hackenberg tried to get it away, but Jabril Black was quick to get to him. He's had a nice second half.
Jabril Black is exactly what Michigan's defense needed. They need somebody to make a play. And this time, he just runs past Jesse James. Doesn't even block him. He gives him a look block.
So Sam Thicken is on to try to tie this game. He's shown great accuracy and distance range. He made a 54-yarder 2 weeks ago right here at home against Kent State. This from 47 to tie the game.
Missed it.
And he kept it to the left the whole time. The target stayed, and it was off target. So a missed opportunity for Sam Thicken and Penn State. Michigan maintains their 3-point lead.
It's been.
We got Colts Chargers come Monday night. Coverage begins with Monday Night Countdown at 6:30. And then the game kicks at 8:25 on ESPN. And let me tell you something. Stanford could use Andrew Luck right now back in college because they're trailing Utah at the half. Number 5 team in the country is trailing by 7 at Utah. And we've got a good one right here at Beaver Stadium. Joe Tessitore, Matt Millen, and Maria Taylor with you as Michigan is trying to stay unbeaten this year. 3-point lead here at Penn State. And the talented Jeremy Gallen moving the chains out to the 44-yard line.
Yeah, in the second half, they found 21. In particular, in the end of the third into this fourth, they knew Jeremy Gallen's the guy who can move the chains. Look, Tess, going into this game, we expected to see a lot of the run game. Well, the Penn State defense took that from the Michigan offense. And so Devin Gardner effectively became their run game. And now it's up to him to be able to find Gallen here in this fourth quarter. So far, they've had a little success.
It's been all Devin Gardner. And then costly turnovers for Penn State that Michigan cashed in on. That's how they started this second half rally as they were trailing by 11 at the half. And now Fitz Toussaint straight up the middle. He only had 4 yards prior to that run. Now look at the running game for Michigan. And you'll see how the conventional run game just hasn't been there. It's been Gardner with his athleticism, with 98 yards, and then Toussaint and Green struggling against that Penn State front. Second and 5. Play action. Gardner, pressured, spins free somehow. Extending the play and then taken down for just a gain of 1. Boy, he is so capable when the rush comes in on him.
Well, he was able to make a miss because that's a big-time rush. Devin Gardner, I can't say enough about him. All night long, he has been a stud. Here he comes again. Daquan Jones has played a great game himself, but 3rd and about 3.
And 107,000 roaring, looking for a 3rd down stop here.
Have to get somebody on Devin Gardner. You have to put your eyes on to take care of his legs.
And it's complete to Dillio for a 1st down for Michigan. Tackled by Mike Hull.
Nicely done by Gardner. Sees the coverage, and it was wide open back underneath. Dillio just working in the slot, nothing there. Gardner finds it.
And this drive could be a really nice response after Penn State came down the field. They missed the 47-yard attempt that would have tied the game. And now Michigan moving the ball against that Penn State defense. Here's Gardner again off play action. Going to launch it to the end zone, and he completes it to Funchess for a touchdown. Once again, big play Gardner to Devin Funchess. 37-yard touchdown strike. They went for 59 yards in the first half.
Well, Glenn Carson is going to have to run, and that's a mismatch. You get Funchess on Carson, that's a foot race that Carson's going to lose every time. The key to that whole thing was excellent protection and allowed Gardner to step up and make the throw. What a game he's having.
What a weapon Funchess has become. 112 yards receiving for their 6'4", 235-pound tight end. And he can beat you right down the middle.
Chocolate chip.
You're watching number 18 Michigan take on the Penn State Nittany Lions. Due to time constraints, we're moving ahead in our coverage. And Hackenberg has missed on his last six passes. Third and 14. And he connects here. It'll depend on the mark of the ball there to Kyle Carter. But it'll be fourth and inches.
He's short.
And it's Bill O'Brien who went for it on fourth and one from his own about 32-yard line in the first half tonight.
Michigan has won the battle when they've tried to go in short yardage situations. You know, the way football is going now, when everybody's running the spread and everybody's running zone reads, and the only place really left to be able to find the toughness of your team is short yardage and goal line. That's really about it. And so Michigan, in the short yardage situations test, they have been money. They have been physical.
We're being told that the Big Ten replay officials are reviewing this mark of Kyle Carter's reception. As you can see, he's down. Remember, that yellow line is unofficial. He brought out the chains and he was well short. So they will let him go here at fourth and one. They stopped him earlier tonight.
Big Quentin Washington, Jabril Black on the inside. They've been the muscle to that defense.
And Penn State able to muscle their way over the right side of that line with Bill Belton. Hackenberg gets this complete to Felder. He's looked Felder's way a few times tonight, and he's done so with success.
Big cushion on the outside, and he's able to recognize it. Felder just pulls back underneath. That's pitch and catch.
And there's the strong arm to Allen Robinson. You get a look at the arm talent of the 18-year-old Christian Hackenberg.
But Tess, there's something on the other end that's maybe more impressive, and that's the powerful hands of Allen Robinson. Watch him snatch his thing. Keep it out away from his body and still comes down with it. That's impressive.
So here comes the true freshman trying to cut into this Michigan lead. Delay handoff, Belton. And Belton works his way down to about the 18-yard line. Under 8 minutes to play.
I think they look like a different offense with Belton in the backfield. It gives them a little bit more speed that they hadn't had.
And forced his hand to Bill O'Brien when Zach Zwinak fumbled on the first play of the second half. And that sparked the Michigan comeback. Michigan had a forced fumble scooped up return for a touchdown by Frank Clark to open up this second half.
False start, offense, number 77, 5-yard penalty. It remains second down.
Brady Hoke doesn't wear those headsets on one side. Meanwhile, you got the play caller, the head coach calling the plays on the other. It's Bill O'Brien trying to manage his young quarterback, Christian Hackenberg. You said earlier, thinned out things just a little bit, simplify it, know what he can do and can't do and what he's capable of. He's well ahead of schedule in his maturation. But this second half has been a challenge. Second and 11 now. Held on a little long, and finally they got to him. It was Frank Clark, the first to arrive at Hackenberg.
Yeah, he had plenty of time to make the throw. So what happens at the outside? A nice job of the Michigan defense in coverage. You know you're going to go to Allen Robinson. It's Allen Robinson on the comeback. Nothing's there. You're looking at the top side. Both fell there. Now, the middle was open. He didn't have his eyes there right away. Sets up this third.
Third and 14 after the sack. Low snap. Hackenberg. He was being pressured. That was Jared Wilson coming all the way around from that safety position to get after Hackenberg.
That's a good call by Greg Madison, their defensive coordinator. He brings the pressure off the edge. He wants that ball to come out fast. You're going to jump your coverage, have the ball come out quick. Hackenberg wasn't able to get it out, forced a bad throw, set up this field goal of 43 yards.
Remember, Sam Ficken missed from 47 not long ago when he could have tied the game. Now from 43. Little funny action, but the result he wanted. And Penn State is only down a score.
There's a lot that goes in to a field goal. You got to have a great snap, you have to have a great hold, and you have to have the great kick. They got all three, and we'll be right back.
Good Hands Play brought to you by Allstate. Matt, we're going to spread love where we usually don't go with it, because Adam Geiger, the holder, is playing in his first college game, thrown into duty here as the holder in this pressure spot of 107,000, playing against undefeated Michigan. Oh, and he's done his job with good hands.
Yes, do you know how hard that is to do? It's easy to do it out back. It's easy to talk about it. But you sit yourself in front of 110,000 people, and all eyes are on you. You have to be perfect. Adam Geiger, that's a good job.
Dennis Northfleet on the return here. A good return by Northfleet. You know, they need guys like Geiger because of the circumstances in the wake of the Sandusky sex scandal. The NCAA with the punishment. And the original sanctions had the limitations of 15 recruits this February and only 65 on scholarship. But those were revised. So they're allowed to sign 20 this coming winter and have 75 total scholarships on the team. And then eventually get back to the full 25 and 85 total by 2016. Those revisions coming in just this season. It's Toussaint. And Toussaint was 7.5 on that run.
And while all those scholarship numbers are significant, none of that matters down on the field right now. Right now, it's time for defense, somebody on that defense, to make a big play. Conversely, it's time for the offense of Michigan to have a little bit more balance. It can't be completely on Devin Gardner.
That was Toussaint's longest run of the night, if you can believe that. They have struggled from that tailback position. Second and 3. And this time, he's going to get the necessary yardage for the first down.
Tess, that's exactly what they need. Michigan needs to be able to control the ball, take the air out of it right now, and run that clock down. You have 5.5 minutes to go in this game. You want to control this thing. It's on your offensive line and your running game.
Remember, that offensive line is without their best player, arguably the best player on the team, Taylor Lewan. Guy who could have left to be a top pick in the NFL draft a year ago, made a decision to come back, left the game with an apparent injury before the half. Toussaint getting some work here now, and that time coming up was Jordan Lucas.
That's really well done by Lucas to see it and fill. What they're trying to do right now is make Michigan run sideways, so they're trying to spill everything out to the outside. So everybody has their gap control inside, you spill it, then Lucas, he's the guy, he's got to make the hit, and he has. Second and 10.
Play clock came down and hit double zeros. Did they get the timeout? They're going to give it to him. As Devin Gardner was checking at the line, and then that play clock was stressing him a bit. We'll take a short break and come back. Second and 10 Michigan when we do. Matt Millen, Maria Taylor with you for what is the yearly spectacle here at Beaver Stadium, an all-stadium whiteout. And they need every bit of that 107,000 plus roaring for a defensive stop. Michigan up 7 with 4:18 to play, second and 10. Derek Green, the freshman, had no chance. Penn State coming right after him.
They drop down to an 8-man front. That's Wortman, number 5, who makes the tackle. But they're crowding the box. What John Butler, Penn State's defensive coordinator, is doing, he's saying, look, we're going to give you numbers. We're daring you to go ahead and throw it. Well, they took the bite. It sets up this third and about 13.
So here's the chance to get the ball back. Third and 12.
Have to keep somebody on Devin Gardner. His feet can beat you here.
And there's a penalty marker down on the near sideline as Jeremy Gallen was locked up with Amos.
That should be uncatchable.
Yeah, that ball was a good 10 to 15 yards downfield, but I'm wondering if Amos made contact well prior to that.
If there's contact before and they call that, they will allow the penalty to stay. If they determine that even with that, the ball could not have been caught, we'll see.
Pass interference, defense, number 4, 15 yards, first down.
So O'Brien making the argument that it was uncatchable, it was well downfield, but watch before that point even happens as he was forced out. Now watch the ball here, Matt. Contact there. Ball still all the way back near the line of scrimmage.
That ball was thrown out of bounds. No one could have caught that ball. However, they did flag him for disrupting the route.
So a first down for Michigan. And they go with Derek Green, and once again that front of Penn State doing their job against both Toussaint and Green. Two pass interference calls tonight against Amos. Three penalties on the evening, and that one was a costly one. And as a timeout will be used by Penn State. Look at O'Brien. He is still bothered by that last penalty flag on third down. John Butler, the defensive coordinator, giving him an earful as well. This big 10 group led by Todd Gearlings.
At one point, we're going to see a bootleg here from Devin Gardner. Watch
this is the play that gave Michigan the first down moments ago.
See, they
barely see the receiver in the frame as he was, the contact was made by Amos.
And Bill O'Brien is making the argument that it's out of bounds, but keep in mind, this throw is only about a yard out of bounds. Anybody running that sideline and would have been had that route would clearly have had a chance to make that catch.
Penn State down to two timeouts, second and 10. Toussaint back in as the lone back. And just about 2.5 yards that time for Fitz Toussaint. And a timeout will be used once again by Penn State.
They're booing, but I got to tell you, I agree with this with the call the way it was.
With the timeout, it gives us the opportunity to bring in our rules expert, Dave Kataya, of course, a longtime head of officials for the Pac-12. Dave, thanks for your time on this. You saw the play moments ago that gave Michigan the first down on the pass interference. How do you read it, Dave? Dave Kataya, our rules expert, noting that the bump takes place at the 40-yard line. Reaction, thank you, Dave, as the ball goes down towards the 26-yard line, and the end result still being booed here by 107,000 in this all-stadium whiteout. Third and 7, and here is Gardner on the ground and advancing the sticks before he is met by Willis.
That's what I was expecting, and that's what Penn State didn't expect. You know, when they spread you out, they're trying to eliminate the numbers in the box. And then the receivers, they go down and get into blocks as quickly as possible. All Devin Gardner has to do is get the first down, which he did extremely well.
Penn State will use their last timeout. Devin Gardner took a heck of a hit here at the end of this.
Oh, he got drilled right here. Head goes down, tries to protect himself. Willis hit him on one side, Amos on the other side. It was a good hit.
Glad you're with us tonight, Joe Tessitore, Matt Millen. Been a great atmosphere here at Penn State with the all-stadium whiteout, and it's been Devin Gardner who's really, he's needed to be the man. A career-high rush total of 109 rushing yards for Gardner tonight.
Well, what they did was they took away the run game. We expected, going into this thing, we were going to see a heavy run game. We said that at the start of the show. And it has been, however, it's been on the feet of Devin Gardner. And he has not disappointed. He's made throws when he's had to make the throws and the big runs when he's had to make runs.
Penn State has exhausted all their timeouts. And a fresh set of downs for Michigan to try to seal the deal. As Fitz Toussaint taken down after a yard by Amos. Coming up next, it'll be Johnny Manziel, number 9 Texas A&M, taking on Ole Miss on College Football Primetime, presented by Hampton Hotels. Texas A&M, number 9. Ole Miss was the trendy team early in the season before they met up with Alabama. Now we'll see if they can get back to what we saw glimpses of earlier. We did a couple of their big wins this season.
Trendy young team. I still believe in that young talent. They have a ton of it.
Toussaint again. And again, trying to battle past that line of scrimmage, but Glenn Carson and Daquan Jones were there.
They're just going to keep it right down the middle, and they're going to, and they'll let this clock go down, put it on their kicker to try to make it, move it out to 10.
Devin Gardner, you can see him and what he's gone through tonight and taking those deep breaths and the pounding he has taken and the effort he has put forth.
He has played a great football game.
Now listen, he had the turnovers in the first half, but in this second half, they needed an offensive player to lean on without their best lineman, Taylor Lewan, and Gardner was the man. Taking all that play clock down, third and nine.
Time. They'll move it back. That's a mistake. They should have snapped the ball.
Offense, number 98, 5-yard penalty. It remains third down.
That also moves them back for a potential field goal to push it to 10. Stops the clock. You got a buck 42.
You got to be careful with the longer field goal attempts, as you see Brandon Gibbons. Now, he's got a leg and he's got talent. Career long of 52 yards.
This is at 50 right here.
Well, let's see what they come up with here on third and 14. Thinking about clock and distance and range and managing the final minute 42 here. And that green line where you see Tucson tackled, that is the field goal range for Brandon Gibbons, as they will let every second of this come down. Michigan with two timeouts remaining. That 35-yard line is the threshold for what Gibbons can offer up. But we'll see how Brady Hoke chooses to manage this.
Well, here's the thing. If he misses the field goal, they get the ball
right
at
there.
The spot.
That's right.
So that's not, you know, you might be better served with a pooch punt right here.
Exactly. Put your defense on the field. But that's why Brady gets the paycheck. Christian Hackenberg's looking up and saying, give me one shot. Of course, Michigan has had many close calls already this year.
The Zips have the lead in the Big House.
Milwaukee, Michigan, back on top.
Incomplete. Michigan survives.
This is a nightmare right now. Four turnovers tonight. Now it's 21-7.
Ball intercepted. Untouched into the end zone.
For the second week, they're going to survive a major scare.
That was a major scare at UConn, and Akron had that final play of the game, the pass fall incomplete. And now here, this second half comeback against Penn State that still has 57 seconds remaining in a fourth and 17.
This is a smart move by Brady Hoke.
Agreed. Look for the pooch punt here and play it safe. And it just goes in for a touchback. So it'll be 50 seconds, no timeouts, and an 18-year-old taken to the field to try to become a legend.
So you wanted to play major college football.
Welcome to the bigs, my friend.
Exactly. So here we go.
You know, and Bill O'Brien said, guys, the bowl ban is out there, and you don't get many big night opportunities like this. So have fun. Enjoy it. This is your chance. Here's Hackenberg on first down. And that was Robinson trying to stretch for it, but he couldn't stay in. So it leaves 45 seconds.
All he needs is first downs to move the chains. You'll get into position to take a shot. You can't take a shot here.
Oh, look at his foot there,
Matt.
That's
a first. That's a first down.
That is an incredible balance job.
One foot
by Robinson.
Ball is controlled right there. One foot down, the other one in the air, not touching. That's a catch.
And you can see us zoom in there. That is an incredible job of balance by Allen Robinson. And as you see the zoom up to the hands, you saw the left foot down, that right foot still floating to our look above the grass. Let's see here again.
That's a catch.
That is impressive. Their best playmaker as the replay team will look at this one through. Remember, on the field, it was called incomplete, so they need that indisputable video evidence to say otherwise, and team in our production truck gave them a heck of a look there.
It's a great job by the guys downstairs. This is probably the most definitive.
Left foot pinned, right foot still striding.
And the ball was controlled.
Which is a critical aspect. You have to have firm control all the way through the motion.
That's it. That's where he gains control right there. The foot is down in the air. They haven't announced it yet, but the other officials are moving the chains.
After further review, the receiver did get 1 foot down and completed the catch. It will be a first down Penn State at the 34-and-a-half yard line. First down.
Good job by Steve Newman, the Big Ten replay official. It is a first down for Penn State. Ball out to the 34-yard line, 45 seconds remaining. No timeouts. The true freshman quarterback, Hackenberg, looking to tie up this game. Steps up, airs it downfield, and that ball is complete. Brandon Felder, Penn State's in business, folks. Watch out.
They're going to clock it right here. He's got to maintain control. Clock stops to move the chains. Clock it and live for another down. Oh, what a phenomenal catch by Felder.
He's had a few big moments tonight, has Felder.
What you have to be able to do right here, Tess, is you've got to get to a position. So he needs about maybe 15 yards more, 15 yards, and then you can think about taking a shot. You don't have to eat it all up. You got plenty of time, 35 seconds. The clock will stop as you move the chains. Put yourself in a position to make a better throw than a prayer.
Here's Hackenberg. He's going to go for it right here. And Robinson comes down with it at the 1 yard line.
So much for being patient. That is the best that you can see out of Allen Robinson. Watch this. Unbelievable. Hand is down, inbounds.
A 6'2" cornerback in Stribling went all the way up, and somehow, someway, Robinson hauled it in. Can you believe this finish by Penn State?
The rolling on the field is a catch completed at the half-yard line inbound. The previous play is under further review.
Well, Robinson needs to go 2-for-2 now with the replay officials.
Now, what Penn State needs to do, and Michigan, is forget what they're doing upstairs. What you need to do right now is get the next play in. Look at the hands. Phenomenal. Great body awareness. Phenomenal kinesthetic sense. But look, while they're reviewing, get your plan put in place, both defensively and offensively. And at one point, Greg Madison is going to have to roll the dice with pressure. They have not gotten pressure at all, as Robinson, again, just a beautiful play.
His entire body comes down inbounds, and the ball looks to be short of the goal line. But with 27 seconds remaining, as long as this stands, they are knocking on the door of tying up this game. No timeouts left when this drive started. Robinson had the tiptoe on the sideline to move the chains, and then that. Wow.
You can't teach that, Tess. You either have it or you don't have it. Allen Robinson, he's got it.
And let me offer this.
After review, the receiver did make a catch inbounds at the half-yard line.
As they sit a yard away, Michigan is not allowed a rush touchdown this season.
If you're going to try a rush, this first down is it. Other than that, you got to throw the football or roll him. They're going to take a timeout.
And Grady is going to use his last timeout. Coach Hope is going to gather the troops.
What a phenomenal end to this game.
And keep in mind that Michigan drive when they were marching down, when they were taking time off, and then the penalty backed up, and they made the decision to play it safe, to pooch punt, to put the defense on the field.
But Tess, it was the right move.
It was.
It was the smart move to do. What you would have liked to have seen, however, was a better punt. He kicked it into the end zone and effectively got 15 yards out of it. You wanted to kick that thing down and let it roll around.
Well, what you could have had is a drive that finished with points.
That would have been preferable. But of course, we could have said that all game long.
It has been a wild one, a game that saw Penn State jump out in the first half, 21-10. A game that saw the second half start with a scoop and score, fumble recovery, and Michigan storm to a 10-point lead.
This looks and smells to me like play action to the tight end.
We'll go I formation with Belton as the tailback. The bigger back, Zwinak, we haven't seen or heard from him since that fumble. Here it is, folks, first and goal. Quarterback sneak, the freshman. Touchdown. The ball came loose, but the far official says touchdown, and they're an extra point away. He crossed that line, and the whiteout is rocking.
Good job there. Right there, it's a touchdown. That's a good call.
And the ball came loose well after that, once he was already laying prone.
Good decision by the freshman to take what is given him and get to the outside, not in the middle where they had not had any success at all. He scores that first rushing touchdown since the 13 Outback Bowl.
Now Sam Thicken.
The previous play is under further review.
Now they'll take a quick look. This final drive has basically turned into CSI State College as they've been inspecting each and every play throughout it. But man, oh man, has it been phenomenal to see it play out.
I love CSI.
What high drama here.
Low man wins. Boy, that's... See, now what you have to watch there is that his forearm made him down. So it's where his forearm was, where the ball was when the forearm hit. That's where they're going to mark it.
Once it crosses that plane.
See, right there.
Nothing else matters.
Right there, where the ball is when his elbow, where his forearm hits, that's where they'll mark that ball. Let's see if it's, let's see exactly. It's not the hand. Hand's fine. The ball's, that's a touchdown.
Once the ball crosses the goal line, everything subsequent to that doesn't matter.
After further review, the ruling on the field of a touchdown is confirmed.
So remember when Bill O'Brien said that the most improved player on my team is the place kicker? And then yesterday when he said, I'm going to go with a guy that's never held for kicks before, never played in a game before, Adam Geiger, said to the young man, are you nervous? Well, let's see how those nerves hold up now for both parties to tie the game. You'll never hear 107,000 quieter than the breath right before that PAT. We are tied here at Beaver Stadium. Don't you love it, folks?
Allen Robinson had himself a relatively quiet day, and this is the sign of a great player. Until they needed a play to be made, he showed up.
You're interested in seeing the start of Texas A&M Ole Miss, you can do so on ESPN News. If you have a heart and pulse, stay right here. 5 plays, 80 yards in just 23 seconds remaining, or 23 seconds used up, 27 seconds remaining, as Christian Hackenberg, highly touted, the guy who, when the NCAA sanctions came down on this football program, gathered up, came here, talked things over with Coach O'Brien and said, I'm sticking with my verbal commitment, and rallied the troops of other recruits to stay the course here. And now the 18-year-old, already with a big notch in his belt.
Remember when Bill O'Brien told his team, go out and enjoy it, take the opportunity that presents itself. They just did.
And now an opportunity for Michigan, who used all their timeouts on that last drive. And here is Dennis Northfleet. And can Northfleet get to the edge? Not a bad return, leaving 21 seconds.
All he has to do is get. You can use the whole field test. The clock will stop. 21 seconds is a lot of time. You're at the 35-yard line. He's got to get about 40 yards, 35 yards.
Well, that is Brendan Gibbons, who has a career long of 52. But let me offer this. Kickoff specialist and punter Matt Weil was attempting 60-yarders in warm-ups, so they could go in either direction here based on circumstances. Well, let's see if this guy can make a little magic. Devin Gardner, he's had such a great night so far. Gardner. Downfield he goes, and it's caught by Jeremy Gallen. Don't go anywhere. 13 seconds remaining, and Michigan has moved it down to the 40-yard line. That would be a 57-yard attempt. They have the kickers on the roster to give it a go.
What Penn State has to be able to do here is take away Gallen and Funchess. Make someone else beat you. It can't be Gallen. It can't be Funchess. If you're sitting in the zone, you have to be aware and plaster those guys, which means you jump that coverage. Stay on it.
13 seconds remain. No timeouts. They clock it here. Remember, there's a new rule in college football in terms of clocking the ball after a temporary stoppage that could come into play here. But 12 seconds to play. And Gardner trying to get one chance here, one chance to stay unbeaten. 5-0, it's been a roller coaster ride all season long, so why not one little ascent and dip and see which way it goes? Here's Gardner to the sideline, caught and out, Justice Hayes, and it's right on that field goal range line of Brandon Gibbons.
That's really smart football. They ran everybody out, they took Gibbons and ran him back underneath. So you're getting your coverage backed off. Defensively, you want to try to keep things in front of you. They took advantage of it.
Remember, Gibbons had the game winner in the 2011 Sugar Bowl against Virginia Tech. He had the game winner 2012 against Michigan State. Will he have the game winner here in the whiteout at Beaver Stadium? It's just short. 52-yard attempt was straight, but he needed a little more boost.
He didn't get all of the ball. Couldn't get his whole leg into it, and it was just a tad short. Now,
I'll tell you, he had really good rotation on that, though.
Yes.
And he had the target, but 52, it's always a challenge to dig into it and get that one iron out rather than that comfortable seven iron.
I don't know about golf, but I know this. Before this game started, you told me.
I did.
It was going to be an overtime game.
Blame me, Millen.
That's right.
Blame me. I said overtime. You up for it? Here it is, folks. The whiteout with a comeback from the home team and more thrills and chills to come.
It's been
so. Overtime has arrived, and Penn State will be on offense first. Both teams will start from the 25. Bill Belton now, and Belton inside the 20-yard line to the 18.
Belton has that burst that this offense has not had. We've talked about that a few times, but their concern with him was whether he could do it in big games. He's shown that he has.
Now Penn State quickly up to the line as Hackenberg then checks with Coach O'Brien.
get a one-on-one on the top side all by himself. Rotated this way.
Hackenberg. He is taken down that time by Chris Wormley.
That's a big play by Wormley. Really big play. They needed something. They needed a stop. They needed something to happen. And Wormley's the guy who's able to do it. Watch him on the inside. Again, it's a mess up in Diffenbach. Never got out there on the outside of the guard. And Wormley is able to make the play.
So Wormley coming up with the sack, and it's third and eight. It's a big opportunity for Michigan to slam the door early in this overtime. Here's Hackenberg. And that ball falls to the ground. He was looking for Brandon Felder. Hackenberg took a bit of pressure there.
That's Clark again. That boy, Countess is right there. That could have been a pick.
So Sam Ficken made from 45 and 43, missed from 47, and this from 40.
Missed it.
Corkscrewed midway, and now Michigan will have a chance to win it in overtime and stay perfect on the year. They are the most curious, unbeaten team in college football, and now they'll get their at bat.
That was a squirrely kick. It kind of
sure was
like a knuckleball.
Well, it didn't have the perfect end over end rotation and took its twists and turns off the leg of Ficken. And now the defense has done their job as Ficken gets some support. And now Devin Gardner, who's rushed for over 100 yards, passed for three touchdowns. He will look for the win here and give possibly Gibbons a chance to redeem himself. Fitz Toussaint. Once again, that front of Penn State has been able to corral Fitz Toussaint all day long.
Devin Gardner has been their playmaker, and Gallen down the stretch.
And there is Gibbons already sitting on a 41-yard attempt if they don't advance it any further. Fifth-year senior, will he get his chance here? Second and nine. Toussaint again. And just about a yard that time, so it'll be third down.
If you notice, Tess, what they're doing is they're keeping it on the left hash. And that's for their kicker. And so they're content. They have great confidence in the fact that their guy can make this kick. So they're keeping it to put him in the best position on that hash mark.
Gibbons at one point had made a school record 16 straight field goal attempts. Third and seven. And they are going to center it for Brandon Gibbons. So it'll all come down to Gibbons. He had a shot at a long one at the end of regulation, but with the defense having shut down Penn State, they could manage this series and trot him right back out. Penn State will use their one timeout that they're handed in overtime. See what Gibbons has done tonight. The 52-yarder, the lone miss right before our overtime. But as we said, he has come through in pressure situations before. The Sugar Bowl against Virginia Tech, the rivalry game against Michigan State. And here in front of 107,000 in an all-stadium whiteout, he can leave the Michigan hero. They came flying in off the edge. They went up the middle. And they rejected Gibbons.
Great push. Oh, nicely. Oh, that's just a phenomenal job on the inside. I can't see who got it, Tess. Did you see the who got it? Boblitz, 84.
They got a really good push. Wartman came darting in. The push straight up the middle did well. And a blocked field goal attempt. And Bill O'Brien lives to fight another overtime. And Brady Hoke says, what is with this 2013?
Everybody loves bacon. The sizzle, the scent, the melt.
The all stadium whiteout with just a patch of maize and blue. So now Michigan will be on offense to begin this second overtime. And Fitz Toussaint is taken down at about the 22-yard line.
Different game plan now when you have the ball first. And so the last time all they needed was a field goal, they played to that. Now it could be a field goal, but you're playing for first downs to put yourself in a position for six.
Second and seven. Quick strike to Gallen, and Gallen will have a first down for Michigan.
That's really an excellent play call, and Devin Gardner was right on the money. What you're going to do, they've been running this play inside. So here's the play action. Look at his eyes back outside. Because the coverage was backed off of Gallen, and he's able to hit that strike. Well done by Gardner.
Gardner is taken down for a loss that time by Deion Barnes.
He was reading Barnes. Barnes didn't bite. They'd run that a few times, and they've been handing it off to Toussaint. This time, Barnes kept his eyes directly on Gardner, sets up this second in about, whatever, 13 maybe.
Second and 13. They bring four against Gardner. He launches to the five and is batted away at the last second by Mike Hall.
That is a great play and great timing by Hall. His back is to him, is going to Jake Butt, number 88. And watch, but his back is to him. Read the eyes of the receiver. When he looks, you make your move. That is a phenomenal play. And sets up a huge third down.
Third and 13. Trip stack, and now they motion out of it with Funchess. He is such a tough matchup in a spot like this. Let's see if he looks his way. Gardner, he's gonna tuck it, run it, and he loses his helmet as he is taken down inside the 10-yard line, and it'll be fourth down there.
Well, I loved right there what I saw out of Devin Gardner. That is phenomenal determination. He was going to get that no matter what. Great coverage on the outside. It opened up, and he went for it.
So Brandon Gibbons comes back out with Drew Dilio holding. Missed the 52-yarder. Locked to win it in the first overtime. And now just a simple 25-yarder unless the script writers have come up with more zaniness. Penn State will have their chance.
Ready to bend metal and shape your future? UTI is the answer. Our collision repair.
Remember, we are one play away from this game being a Penn State win or a Michigan win as Penn State starts here with Bill Belton. Touchdown wins it for Penn State.
They're going
a stop wins it for Michigan, and they will go up tempo. Second and five. The up tempo has worked when they've gone with the changeup. They stay on the ground with Belton, and he is taken down at the line of scrimmage. As it was Morgan corralling him.
Morgan made a nice tackle, but Belton missed a cut. He had a cut back to the inside and missed it. Sets up this third down.
Bill O'Brien, who acts as the play caller. Third and four. Christian Hackenberg, who had that miraculous drive to force overtime, the 18-year-old now in this pressure spot.
It's on Hackenberg completely.
Incomplete.
He had the top side wide open. They had a double stack to the top side. He went back to the tight end on the inside. And that. So he's got to you've got to kick the ball here and try
Sam
for the field
Ficken,
goal.
The junior, who improved so much throughout the course of last year after his early season struggles. O'Brien said he's the most improved player on this Penn State team. To force a third overtime. He's 2 for 4 on the night. This from 36. And they can all breathe here in State College.
Hello. This is where we do that bundling thing. Let's see what you...
Back in 2002, Michigan took an overtime victory against Penn State. Penn State has won the last three. Didn't meet in recent years. 2010, the last meeting. Next year, they're going to be division rivals. Penn State first on offense in the third overtime. How about the end around, and it's fumbled! And Michigan's Frank Clark jumps on it. He had the fumble return that sparked the comeback here in the second half as he scored a touchdown, and now he comes up huge as Robinson put it on the ground.
I wonder if Robinson even had it. It was the right call. It was wide open on this side. Let's see what happens. Oh, no, that was his. That's completely on him. Allen Robinson had it. It was a good handoff. He just never got the handle.
Frank Clark with two key fumble recoveries. And now Michigan in the third overtime will win with a score. They played it conservative the last time they were in this spot. Let's see what the play calling looks like here. Toussaint, I don't know that he even got back to the line of scrimmage.
Yeah, he lost a yard, but Tess, I'm going to agree right here with Michigan's play calling. That's Al Borges. He knows he's got an excellent kicker. Yeah, he got it blocked the last time. But if you just keep it down the line, I like my chances with my kicker here. I would continue to run the football.
Need those big guys up front to do their business when it comes to special team field goal. Last one was blocked. And this goes to Gallen, and he's right near the sticks at the 15-yard line.
Third down. Nice throw. Good confidence on that throw. I like that out of Devin Gardner. He wasn't afraid of the situation. We love to see how guys respond in these situations. And Gardner came out of that play action knowing exactly where he was going with that ball.
Third and one. Toussaint is the tailback in the I formation. They may be taking a look at the spot of the ball here, or the catch by Gallen.
Probably reviewing the spot test. He comes back to the ball.
Let's see the spot here.
Yeah, see that may
forward progress may have been at the 15-yard line.
Yeah. It looks like the ball was over the 15-yard line.
And then Adrian Amos brought him back a yard. So let's see if they respot this.
It's where the ball is. Yeah, that looks like it's on the 15.
Remember, the replay official played such a big role in the reason why we're even in overtime with the acrobatic catches by Allen Robinson on that miraculous last drive by Penn State. But the fumble here to start the third overtime. We'll see how costly it is.
This is going to be a first down test.
And it's Frank Clark with a couple of fumble recoveries. Sparked the comeback in the second half with a fumble return for a touchdown, and here jumped on that mishandled end around that Robinson couldn't hold on to.
The ruling that the runner was short, third down, it stands as called.
Oh, that surprises me. It looked like he was over. What sets up third and inches?
So third and short with the ball cresting shy of the 15-yard line. Fitz Toussaint didn't get there as Daquan Jones made yet another tackle.
Daquan Jones played a heck of a football game.
So here comes Gibbons. And Penn State will use their one timeout here in the third overtime. They got the ball first here in the third overtime, and they called the end around, and Robinson couldn't secure it, and Frank Clark did. And that has put Michigan in position to stay unbeaten if Gibbons can make this field goal. He's missed two of the last three attempts, but keep in mind, one was the 52-yarder. The other one was that exceptional effort by the Penn State front to get up. Kicks a bit of a low ball, but if he can get this one up, and pure and true, Michigan will be 6-0.
Missed it. Unbelievable.
Can you believe that? He misses the 33-yarder that was lined up, set up, served up every which way for him.
He just pushed it here, Tess.
Has your phone turned you into a control freak? Like scoring the perfect table? Or getting a better seat?
Each kicker in overtime, one for three. Christian Hackenberg, the freshman quarterback, was marvelous at the end of the fourth quarter. As Taylor Lewan, the All-America offensive lineman, has just been an interested viewer like the rest of you. He was injured in the first half. And Christian Hackenberg, with that courageous effort at the end of regulation, put his team in position. And now overtime number four. Here's Gardner. Can he get around the edge? He just has to throw it away.
Deion
Barnes was tracking him down.
That's the second time they've tried Deion Barnes to that side. And it's the second time Barnes has come through. Once they tried him on the option, and he was able to run him down, and this time he held his discipline to the top side. I was waiting for that with Gardner with the boot. Second down.
Was beyond the reach that time for the outside of Drew Dilio. be third and 10. Play clock is counting down.
There it goes. Flag is down.
Delay.
That's impossible
offense
to happen, Tess.
5-yard penalty. It remains third down.
And he's gonna yell. You cannot allow that to happen. That comes as much from the sideline with the clock, with the call not getting in, and the quarterback being in control out there.
Brandon Gibbons with that 33-yard miss. And now a third and 15 on the other end of the field for his Michigan offense. And Gardner's going to be well short. And Gibbons is going to have to go back out there.
That looks like a 41. 41 yarder. A little short of that.
Remember, he had a streak of 16 straight. But with the pressure on, things have gone south for Brandon Gibbons. Can he pull out of it? Officially listed as 40. And Michigan takes the lead, 40-37.
This is for my mother.
So we will keep you up to date on the injury status of Johnny Manziel down there at Ole Miss. As you saw him struggling in pain there. As Penn State opens up overtime number four with Bill Belton, who has gotten the majority of the work here in the second half for Bill O'Brien's offense. Second and 5 with the ball to 20. Touchdown wins it for Penn State. Field goal sends us to 5 overtimes, and a turnover wins it for Michigan. Here's Belton. He slipped, and he had a hole on the left side of the line, and he knows it.
Still 3rd and 4. 3rd and 5-ish. You're right. He had a hole to the backside, wasn't able to get there. So what you have to do here is just get the first down. You don't have to get anything big, Tess. Just move the chains.
Third down and 4. Inside carry, Belton. Can he get there? It's going to depend on the spot here, as Belton was driving those legs, and it looks like they're marking him short. Yes, they will mark him short of that 15-yard line.
They're going hurry up.
This is hurry up on a fourth down. And you could see them sprinting out.
Bill O'Brien.
It was.
That's the fastest 40 time Bill O'Brien has ever run.
Bill O'Brien, the former linebacker in the Ivy League at Brown, sprinted like he was in the NFL combine here to get this timeout. He wanted it. And with that timeout, it gives the replay official the opportunity to look at the spot, we understand, of that last play, the run by Belton. Needs to touch the 15-yard line to be a first down. And ball was tucked against his chest in his arm as he went forward. At first glance, I think they got it right. And that offense is on the field, fourth down. Fourth and less than a yard with the game on the line. If Michigan stops them, they win. He got it.
Oh, man, let me tell you something. That is some That's a gutsy call, to say the least, out of Bill O'Brien. There's another word that was going to come out, but let me tell you, that was all of what it was. That is
everything O'Brien said tonight was supposed to be. You go out there and you have fun and you play to win. Still more work to be done, though, as Belton converted on fourth and one. Here's Hackenberg to the end zone. Oh, through the hands of Allen Robinson. He was covered by Blake Countess, the very talented sophomore.
Nice coverage by Countess all over him. Now, that was a tiny little window for Hackenberg to push it into, and he did. This is on Allen Robinson. That should have been caught. That should have been six. If you're a great player, you make the great play.
Second and 10. Keep it on the ground on the inside, and Belton to the 11-yard line.
Third and about eight. That'll be interesting to see what Bill O'Brien calls, if he's going to play for the tie. He's in good shape right here. If he puts the ball in the hands of Hackenberg, Hackenberg has to be smart just in terms of making a safe throw. Cannot get sacked. Probably will try to run it, I would think. Yeah.
Kid has shown such guts and regulation just to arrive here. Third and eight. Here's the 18-year-old. Look at the time. To the end zone. Incomplete. Flag is down. He was looking at Robinson, and Jared Wilson got in on him.
Excellent protection. Hackenberg, boy, I'll tell you, this kid does not lack for confidence. He trusts that arm. That he threw it into a tiny window.
No, confidence is not lost on this young man.
Pass interference. Defense. Number 22. Foul occurred in the end zone. The ball's placed at the 2-yard line. First down.
He's looking to slay the dragon, and he went right to the heart of it here on this throw.
Nicely done in protection. Look at that tiny window. Wow, that's... Again, he's looking for Robinson. Robinson comes clean. That ball was good enough to be caught. That's two of them.
This Michigan defense tighten up here down at the goal line to stay unbeaten, give themselves a chance. First and goal. Belton to the edge. Penn State has done it. A classic comeback. A thriller in four overtimes. And Devin Gardner can just sit back and watch as the whiteout explodes here at Beaver Stadium. Wow!
We talked about the ability of Belton to be able to bounce it and use the speed. He's the difference in that play. His vision, his ability to cut, and Bill O'Brien is one happy coach.
A coach who went for it on fourth and one in the fourth overtime. And Devin Gardner, on a night when he gave so much, his team suffers their first loss of the year. And how about this scene? High above 107,000. An all-stadium whiteout that they will never forget. That's a downright blizzard of celebration. Let's go down to the field to Maria.
Coach, you came over here and went down to your knees and had to take a deep breath. How would you describe the back-and-forth ending of this game?
It was an incredible football game. Give so much credit to Michigan. I got a great football team. I think Coach Hoke does a great job. Our kids just hung in there, and got a great bunch of kids. I took a knee here because I was tired. I wanted to go home, but it's a great win for Penn State.
So they wore you out, but you decided to go for the fourth down and the fourth overtime. Tell me about that decision.
I don't know if our kids could go much longer there. You know, they had given us everything they had. The tanks were empty, and I said, eventually somebody's got to go for it, so I just decided to go for it.
Well, you talk so much about this game being about opportunities. What did you just learn about your team in this game?
Well, just like, you know, we had a bad loss last week, and our kids felt terrible about it. We got a resilient bunch of kids, tough kids. That's what Penn State's all about right here. 108,000 fans cheering us on. It's just a great place.
Congratulations, Coach.
Thank you.
He didn't know if the kids could go much longer. That's why he went for it on fourth down. Let me tell you something, Coach O'Brien. They're going to be going all